Hey there, and welcome friends. My name is Josh, I'm the founder of Technical Writer HQ, and in this video we'll cover what is metadata and why is it important and the role of it in information architecture. Let's go ahead and dive in. So to understand what metadata is, we must tie it to taxonomy. And a taxonomy is a particular categorization of information leveraging metadata. To give you a better idea, let's start with an example of a clothing store. We organized our clothing items by a few different options. We have color, size, type. And each of these options is part of our clothing taxonomy and lives in a hierarchy. With your organization structure in place, in other words, your taxonomy in place, you then need to classify all the information. And metadata helps you do this because the taxonomy itself simply provides an architecture for the organization, but doesn't actually organize it until all information includes metadata. And metadata is the defining attributes and classification of each piece of information, which is why it is leveraged by search engines to understand the content that you write and you publish on the web. And in code, metadata often looks like a list of attributes with associated values indicating the classification of that item. And for a web page, some of those items are as follows, and you might have seen these already. You have your meta title, a descriptive title defining what the website is about. Meta description, a longer form description of the content, often an introductory snippet per se of the content in the page. And you have such things as social media tags. Twitter, Facebook, and other social platforms use specific meta tags so you can control how a post image, title, and description will appear on those platforms when shared. And location and language. Tags used to tell search engines what language or location the content was designed for. And metadata tags can be broad and customized to your needs. In our shop example, each clothing item would need to be tagged for our taxonomy's categories, meaning the metadata might look something like this. You have name, unisex red t-shirt, color, which is red, size, medium, type, which is shirt type, which is t-shirt, and material, which is cotton. These characteristics, once defined for each item, help to populate the taxonomy structure and organize the data. And based off of this metadata, we know we'd expect to find this item in the t-shirt section, organized with other medium-sized shirts. And depending on our taxonomy structure, this may be organized by material or color as well. If you want an example of taxonomy, look at how popular websites configure their main navigation. The main and sub-navigation is often representative of the taxonomy being used to organize information. And looking at, for example, apple.com, we can understand some elements of the taxonomy being used to organize products. The top navigation includes broad, known to consumer categories like Mac, iPad, and iPhone. The secondary navigation, once you select one of those previously mentioned categories, breaks down by product type. You have MacBook Air, MacBook Pro 13 inches, iMac, and iMac Pro. And this aligns how customers follow a journey through the website, often with a product in mind that they want to learn more about. And what is interesting here is that there are many parallels between the digital experience and the in-store experience of most Apple stores. In the physical experience, each table displays represents one of the top navigation items, and within that table is an assortment of product types. And Apple does a great job of aligning their in-store taxonomy and digital taxonomy for finding products. Of course, in Apple's case, this is a very curated experience with a fixed number of products. However, these products still have metadata embedded in them for search purposes. Understanding your taxonomy structure and what metadata you want to show for elements, such as title, author, date, and categories, can help inform your information design. Understandably, these structures can change and should be iterative like the rest of the process. However, having them from the start will ultimately help you understand what templates, pages, and elements you need to include in your information design. And if you have existing content, products, or an existing site that you're redesigning, conducting a content audit before you begin is super important. This involves looking at all the pages, products, and content within your site, understanding what metadata exists already, and understanding where you may have gaps. Pairing this with an analytics tool is a great way to research high touch points with customers today in areas that you can improve your customer journey with restructuring of your taxonomy and metadata. And there we have it. We just covered what metadata is and its role in information architecture. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to go ahead and like it, subscribe to our channel for more videos about information architecture, and I'll go ahead and see you on some of our other videos. Cheers.